I'm back. Hello, this is Amethyst and Atari. Welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. And today, I'll be reading A Traveler's Guide to Bruma, which I found right here in Castle Bruma. A Traveler's Guide to Bruma by Marcius Carvane, Viscount Bruma. In response to the overwhelmingly positive reception that my An Explorer's Guide to Skyrim has received, I have chosen to publish this new text detailing the characteristics of Bruma and its people. It is my hope that this work will enlighten a great many about Bruma's culture and encourage prospective travelers to come and partake in the bountiful experience of life in the Jiral Mountains. Firstly, one must understand that Bruma in many ways defies the traditional Cyrodiilic cultural divide of Kalovian and Nibonese. While Bruma is indeed a Nibonese county, one must always be mindful of the county's strong Nordic heritage and populace. Indeed, some, not least of which the esteemed 3rd edition author Alessia Ottis, have argued that Bruma has more in common with the mead halls and jubilant feasting of Skyrim than the cosmopolitan society of wider Cyrodiil, and indeed, this is a claim I would not dispute. Bruma shares much with Skyrim, its large Nord population, its love for mead, and, last but certainly not least, its love for feasting and good cheer. But despite all of this, it also inherits many positive elements of imperial culture: multiculturalism, diversity, and tremendous value placed on rule of law. Those who have shied away from Skyrim for fear that their race or creed may have led to their ostracizing from the community need not fear this will happen in Bruma, for Bruma is a welcoming and prosperous county indeed. Inside the great walls that surround the city herself, its people know safety and peace. Bruma offers many services also. There are two inns within Bruma, where travelers may rest their weary heads and or drink to their heart's content, the more upper-class Jiral View, and the more lower-class Restful Watchman. As Viscount of Bruma, it would, of course, be improper for me to suggest which inn one should stay at. I will instead simply state a recent statistic from our records. There were, on average, 10 arrests made per week at the Restful Watchman, and only 3 in the lifetime of the Jiral View. Also, 8 of these arrests actually comprised of detaining the innkeeper. Make of that what you will. There are numerous stores and other services available for the traveler with a gilded coin purse. The local Synod Conclave provides magical services, while the Fighters Guild can cater to martial needs. Our smithy, Northern Arms, sells all the arms and armor a traveler could need. And if you want meat, look no further than a cut above, our butcher's shop, run by the feverish Redguard Fatal. Within our marketplace, we also have numerous vendor stalls featuring the many varied goods, including clothing, alchemical ingredients and potions, and even more niche items such as the ancient Nordic artifacts. Those who seek to do business with the Count should simply enter Castle Bruma. Free entry is guaranteed, and the Count regularly holds audience with his subjects. Simpler matters are relegated to the Count's steward, the Honorable Nord Rignar. I would encourage you to present less pressing issues to him for more immediate action. Thank you for reading this, A Traveler's Guide to Bruma. It is my hope that you will visit our fair city sometime soon. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim, A Traveler's Guide to Bruma.